Now we on. Now we recording.
Yes.
What's going on, people?
Take two.
Lord.
What's popping? What's popping, everybody?
How y'all doing?
Let me pull Friday. Up my goggle.
That's what I'm doing too.
I'm telling y'all this because we've recorded this already. We have. And it was good. It was good. We was flowing. It was vibing. So I'm sorry if we seem a little like, hey. We done seen y'all already, but y'all didn't get it.
So we back.
But we're back. We're here. Let's do it.
We're going to talk about Judas.
Oh my God.
Judas and the Black Messiah. When I first heard this title, I'm like,
I wear glasses so much. Did you see me go to push my glasses up and they didn't know my face?
Yeah.
Did you see that?
Yeah. No, it's so hard.
Okay.
It's so hard. You know, it's so hard, like, because I'm talking to you and I'm looking at the screen, but you're like supposed to look at the camera. It's like, it's so weird to me.
Exactly.
Like, I want to look at your face, but I'm like,
I'm doing the same thing because I'm watching us.
Yeah. But I'm like,
then I like make eye contact. Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Let's Talk About It. Today, we will be talking about. Judas and the Black Messiah.
Yeah.
This is take two, so we're being very silly in this one. Because, oh my God, serious matter. Silly around the board. Okay. What'd you think?
I thought it was a heavy movie, but good. It's always great to, you know, learn parts, you know, history, something I was familiar with, but not too familiar with, because I didn't know this story until this movie. Very cast was awesome, very believable.
Yes,
there's a part you see because we're doing this the second time, so I'm like, okay, but I'll just hop right to it. Like, very powerful, yes. very powerful scenes throughout the whole movie. We were speaking about how, you know, you talk about one of the powerful scenes is during the, when they were shooting up the place and how the fiance was protecting his body, and it was a man, right? You know, there was
yes.
a man in the room, and you stated how, you know, it was a powerful scene, and yeah, and I, you know, I agree with you, and I was like, oh, but on the other half, you know, it makes me think of how Black women sacrifice, how we sacrifice ourselves for Black men, and a lot of them is dead, like I said, they dead figure, not literally.
Yeah, they just like,
yeah, and you know, so that part kind of bothered me. I get the whole process. I'm not saying Black women shouldn't, you know, protect the Black man. I'm just saying a lot of times we often sacrifice ourselves and our children because she's pregnant. Me, I'll be under the bed. Deuces. You're already dead. I'm like, what am I gonna do?
No. At that time, and granted, this was in the late 60s, I totally understand, but I just said at that time, boo, we can't live here. Why we up in here with all these people now? I ain't got time. I know it's for the culture. This is for us.
Yeah,
shouldn't we have our own headquarters to the side? And then everybody else, they around it? Shouldn't we do it like that? No? See, that's why I couldn't. I'd be out of order. You know how he said, I think at one point he was like, do you regret, you know, being with me? Like, and having my child. And she did the poem, and she was like, basically, no, dude, I'm here. What you think?
But he said, I'm ready to die for the people.
Yeah, and she was like, whoa. For the people. Yes, we are. But I'm carrying your baby.
Hello.
But, like, what are we doing? And that's something, that's another, I hate to go back to Malcolm and Marie, but that's a power struggle there where it's like, hey, yes, I'm all here for what you're doing. Just like what you said, when we hyping up our man, I'm here.
Right.
Oh, your part, I'm here for you, boo.
But
do you see what I'm doing? Validate what I got going on, please. Right. Then I can better help you. So she was riding all the way. She loved that man, honey. She loves a friend. Fred was putting it on her. Fred said, I am a revolutionary for you, girl. Okay, I ride for you too. And she felt like that. And I think that's why, when I go back to that point where she was over him, mm-hmm. she was like, yo, I'm riding for you. Like, you rode for me, dog. I feel like I have purpose. You believed in what I was saying. Because back then, women didn't really, and still to this day, don't really have a voice.
True.
And you have to further project. Right. Where then he even said, girl, let me hear what you got to say. I value your opinion. I was like,
that part.
Fred, I fucks with you. I did. I thought it was great too. I was like, I secretly did till it was over. God, and that scene was so sad. And then the dude that was standing right beside it was pissing me off. He just standing there like, girl, I'm gonna go first. You, what you gonna do? Okay, girl, I'm gonna see you later. It was like, did they shoot him too? Or did they let them both go?
He was let go. He was let go, and they held her, you know, they had her there by the door, I guess, so she could hear what they was going to do. And I'm like, they could have just, you know, I said, they could have let him bleed out, you know, it's not a good thing either, but they didn't have to shoot him again, you know, but it's just being very wicked. And see, if you call them the devil, you'd be mad, but that's some devil shit. Much. I'm just saying. Yeah. So. Yeah. It's unnecessary. It's very
clear about how certain movies like this make us like you were saying how it was unnecessary.
The overkill, you know, to shoot him like it was, but I understand the message, you know, it's a movie. I get what they was trying to portray and what, you know. I mean, yeah. They said it truly happened, so that's what happened.
Yeah.
So yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's
and we were talking earlier how certain movies like that with that type of tone, even though it's real life and it has happened, it just incites something within us that makes us just
angry.
Like those type of movies. I watch it, but I'm just like
But it's funny though, even though, you know, we may think that those times are far removed, and they're not. Yeah, they're not. Because I mean, the same shit is happening now. You know, the same stuff is happening now. But you know, and it's kind of, you know, and it's like you watch that. Okay, it's not such a far removed, but then it's like, okay, how long? And like my nephew's gonna be, they're gonna be watching this doc, this COVID, this pandemic documentary. They're gonna be watching this. So it's like the same thing.
Yeah, saying I was a part of that.
Yeah. It's like the same.
It's just sad. Yeah. It's very sad. And even to hear that this wasn't that long ago, even for us to say that.
Not long ago at all.
Wasn't that long ago.
No.
Which is very sad. And the same shit is happening, but just to another degree. Like we feel like we progress so much. Well, we don't as a culture. We don't feel like that. But I'm just saying in general, we progress so much as a society. And I'm like, when, where, how?
Yeah.
Just because we can go in the same stores and shit? Like, do you think that is amazeballs? I mean, that's great.
You should be happy.
Look at us like we crazy. Yeah. Other countries are like, they are so far removed. Like, in the hell is going on? This is nuts. Look at them. Gross. It's crazy though. Now the cast.
Excellent.
I told Daniel, what did we say his last name was?
Kaluuya.
Look on the goggle. Kaluuya. I gotta watch an interview with him to say his last name.
Kaluuya.
He was so believable. Kaluuya. And to do that, oh my God, he was great. Lakeith. I rocks with Lakeith. I enjoy him. But for me to not like him at the end of the movie, I was like, yes, you played a sorry man. And I believe you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Lakeith. I believed him.
It was hilarious to me, like how at different points he was trying like to, you know, when he was trying to say it was a rat, like he was trying to throw them off. So like when he was in the in there, and he was like, there's a rat in here. And I try to go off in the place like, oh, and if I find him, I'm like, look at this idiot. Like, really?
I'm going to shoot his ass. And then for him to walk out like.
Yeah. Like, I did that. They're going to think I'm the rat. No, I'm like, dude, okay.
even when he was starting to up the car, like hot wire in the car, and he was like, it's gonna work. Give me a second. Everybody, I was like,
you taking too long to hot wire this. I was like, come on, y'all, he taking too long.
Rev it up now. And the way she took that knife out of her sock, I said, she an OG. She an OG. The dude was in the back seat and he popped up. This is good.
The
now the only thing we were talking about, yeah, go ahead.
The scene when again when he tried to show up himself when it was a scene when the Fred was out of jail. He had come out and it was like in the back alley, and he was like, he opened the trunk, was like, had dynamite.
Yeah,
like, let's go blow up. Nigga, you're doing too much. He was like,
to go get a sandwich. We're not doing that. I thought we wanted a ham and cheese. You doing the most. We said we were going to get something to eat. And you just.
What, let's go blow up the. I'm ready to die. I'm like, dude, if the lead ain't acting so amped up, why you acting like that?
Some people are just too damn extra, but you know people like that.
Oh, yeah.
They just extra for no reason. And you like. Can you do me a favor and calm down? Like, this is too
Come on strange. In the room. Come on in the room. Yeah.
They stay on 22. He's like,
bring it back.
This is too much. William, what did you think at the end when the, you know how all documentaries do where they're like, after so-and-so, XYZ happened, and they give you a whole novel. What did you think about knowing that Fred Hampton was 21 when he was assassinated? Also for William O'Neill to do that CBS, that PBS or whatever it was, and then right after
kill himself,
committing suicide.
That's such a cowardly, move. My thing is like, keep that same energy you had when you infiltrated the thing and you was
that part.
Like if you saw, if you went through all of that for a gas station and $200, why you gonna kill yourself after all? That's a lot. Yeah. So, and to note 21, I mean, very powerful for, you know, at 20, very powerful, man. I mean, and who could imagine what he, you know, what he could have accomplished if he had lived longer. 21, like, he spent how, like, what was it, 5 or 6 years he was locked up?
Exactly. I think it was 5. Yeah, I think it was 5, if I'm not mistaken.
It's sad. But excellent movie. Excellent.
To get back. Yeah, I agree. I agree with your standpoints. And at the same time, at the end, when Lakeith was drawing where everybody was posted up at, I said, you know what? That's the only part of that film that made me go, no, he not. You could draw the setup of Chuck E. Cheese. I don't care what you draw. You could have done anything. But where them people were staying at? Like, that was too much. All because they were saying, hey, we're going to give you up as the informant. Mm-hmm. And they going to boil your nuts, too. What you want? He went to drawing. He said, uh-oh. You want a Picasso painting? What would you like? Do y'all have colored pencils? What? Draw what they clothes look like, too. Like, he was ready. I was like, what kind of pussy-ass shit is this?
They had to tell him twice.
Craziness.
You ain't got to tell him twice. Like, nope. No, ma'am.
Yeah, it was... That's the only part that had me. And aside from the assassination scene, that was a lot. But that was the only other scene that really had me like, this shit, this is some bullshit. Like, I can't. And just how the white people were orchestrating behind the scenes.
Mm-hmm. Like, the FBI.
They said they were like, it's not enough to have them in jail. You doing it. Take the power away, take the voice away. That's it. It's done. Mm-hmm. So just kill them. I was like,
it's like, you know, with the whole thing and when they, you know, okay, you arrested them, you got them out of place. Why you have to burn it down? But look how the community look at the community just rose up and put it back together.
That's right. That's a testament of how we can do things.
We're very powerful.
Yeah, very powerful.
Mm-hmm. But we got a lot of cooks in the kitchen.
Too many chiefs. Yeah, so. Not enough Indians.
So what's on it? We got new names. Mm-hmm. We got a lot of Williams. Sorry if your name is William. I'm sorry. I'm just saying. Yeah.
Yeah. That's true. Would you watch this movie again?
Definitely. Definitely. Definitely.
Yeah. I agree.
I'm not into long movies, and for one to keep my attention and I didn't fall asleep, you got me. We good.
Yes. So if I fall asleep, it's over. I already knock a star if I fall asleep. I don't care how good it was. Boom, I fell asleep.
That's what happened last night. Me trying to watch Wonder Woman. Yeah, okay.
Oh, I didn't start Wonder Woman.
Yeah, but yeah, we're here for that. I'm just saying. Yeah.
So 1 out of 5, I think in our previous, when we reviewed this before, we both agreed it was a 5. We both agreed it was a really good film, and we'd watch it again. And if we say we would watch a film again, that automatically for me gives it a 5. And I was telling people, yo, you gotta watch this movie. Have you seen so-and-so? So if I say that, it's pretty much a really good movie in my book. So I was glad I watched it.
Same here. Thank you for referring me to watch it.
You are so welcome. Yeah, Sam's always, we always go back and forth on what we watch it. And I was like, girl, you gotta watch Judas and the Black Messiah, girl, you gotta watch that. So I'm glad you took my recommendation. And I'm glad you enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So,
but what yes, y'all. Mm-hmm.
You girl, I would say, so what would y'all like us to check out? What are you watching? Yeah. Give us some recommendations down in the comment section. And
please.
You know, let me take your suggestion, give you a shout out. And yeah. Hope you enjoyed this little chat here. Me, I don't enjoy it. My outros, you know, I'll just be like, boom, I'm out. But I'm going to let Tara take it away.
Y'all, please be safe. Keep your mask on at all times while you're out and about. Peace, love, and all that good stuff. God bless. Bye, y'all.